Now here's a great song, I Would Do Anything For Love. This is one of Meatloaf's greatest hits of his entire career. This song was Meatloaf's first ever number one on the US Billboard Hot 100 and on the UK charts. In fact, this song is so impressive, it reached number one in a total of 28 countries, the first being Australia on September 4th of 1993, where it remained at number one for a total of 8 weeks. It also managed to maintain its number one position for 7 weeks here in the UK. So as you can see, this song was a huge hit. It was another of Jim Steinman's much longer songs at 12 minutes in length, and combined Meatloaf's powerful rock style with a soft poetic ballad theme, a classic Steinman combination. And that's not to mention having a pretty awesome music video directed by American film director and producer Michael Bay. Overall, it's just a great song, and one of the most talked about things in this song is the so-called ambiguity of what Meatloaf is singing about when he says he won't do that. Many people ask each other, and according to Meatloaf himself, ask him, what is that? In this video, I will reveal the answer to the big question that is, what is that? Okay, so I gotta admit, when I first listened to this song, I kept asking myself, what is that? I was completely lost. I'd heard some ideas on what that could be, things like lies and deceit, or even things of a sexual nature. After some time, I thought I'd worked out what it was for myself, but I wanted to double check this online. I went through a few different websites to see what other people had posted on their ideas of what that was. I found that there was a lot of people had a lot of different ideas on this, again with the lies, deceit, or sexual nature, some even suggesting things like marriage or having children. One person even made the suggestion that because of the video, it showed that Meatloaf was a vampire, and the one thing he would not do is he would not go after the woman, bite her, and change her into a vampire so that they could be together as the same species. Wow, you're actually that desperate for an answer you're going to rip off Twilight?
You idiot!
Anyway, I eventually found some other opinions which matched my own, and then later on following that, I found the evidence to prove it.
Okay, so the biggest mistake people make is the thinking that there's just one instance of Meatloaf's that. There are in fact 6 instances of that in this song, and all of them clearly stated. So let's take a look at the lyrics and see if we can find these 6. The first 3 that's appear in the 3 choruses of the song, 1 that per chorus. The beginning of each chorus starts off very positive. However, after that little positive paragraph, the next line starts with but, and leads its way into the first that. I'm going to highlight the key areas, and from this you should be able to clearly see what the first that is. We can now see that the first that is forget the way you feel right now. Now from this we can just use the same method and find the that's in the following 2 choruses. This just leaves the last 3 that's to find, and these are found in the last section of the song, the duet with Meatloaf and the woman. Now since I've already spoken on how to identify these that's, I'm just going to throw up the lyrics on the screen and highlight the key parts again so you can see for yourself. Here we can clearly see the final that's in the duet. But there's no need to just take my word for it. I later found out that Meatloaf himself explained this using a blackboard and pointer stick. The clip which you're about to see is Meatloaf giving this very explanation as part of the VH1 Storyteller special.
I heard this song for the first time, and it was sort of like the song No Matter What. I just thought it had an incredible, incredible chorus. Of course, it was, I would do anything for love, but I won't do that. But it was great. But what happens is, I get this question all the time. And I bet if anybody raised, I said, do you have a question? People would raise their hand, and they were going to ask me this question. I'm going to help you out here, okay? What is that? Right? Was that your question? That was it. What is that? I get that question all the time. Well, I'm here tonight to help you out, okay? I'm here. Okay, guys, can we bring in the blackboard? What is that? I know you know. Okay. What is that? In the song, if you hear it, before every chorus, it goes different, and there are different lines every time before every chorus. And I would do, what is that? It's bad. It's backwards. What have they done to me? Okay. All right, here we go. Forget this part. Right here. But I'll never forgive myself if we don't go all the way tonight. I would do anything for love. Boy, whoever wrote this is, I'm killing them as soon as this song. But I won't do that. And every time there's a chorus, I'll never stop dreaming of you every night of my life. I'll do anything for love, but I won't do that. I'll never forget the way you feel right now. I will do anything for love, but I won't do what? Do we know what that is now? Do we understand it? It's the line before every chorus. I'll never forget the way you feel right now. I will do anything for... In other words, you can insert your own line. Maybe in the near future, you might say something like that. You might take her to the door and go, it was great tonight. And I'll never stop dreaming of you. I'll do anything for love, but I won't do that. Now you know what that is.
And there you have it. I hope that now you feel confident that the what is that question has been answered. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed.